day 9 of our shred, and I'm going to do another core workout because it seems like you all like that a lot. I'm going to do it on a bench so you could see me, but this is something that I think would be best on your floor, unless you have a bench and you feel really balanced on it. And know that all these videos I give you of workouts, they're only one set, okay? So everything we do is intended to do it for three times, okay? For the sake of the video, I'm not gonna do it for three times because you don't need to watch me work out, okay? That's not what this is about, me working out with you today. It's not, that's what it's about. It's about showing you how to put exercises together to make a nice group of 4 to 5 exercises or 3 to 4 exercises together, and then doing that whole thing three times, how much more intense it is than just doing it once. Also, I'm gonna do 10 reps today of each thing, but this is intended for you to do 20 of each exercise, and I will explain that as we go. So the first thing I'm gonna show you is if you have a ball, mine has handles, but you can have any ball, you can hold it like this. You can hold a dumbbell side to side like that. What I want you to do is you're gonna be sitting on your floor, so I'll do it this way. You can sit with your legs down in front of a chair too if you want, but I'll do it like if I'm on the floor. So what I want you to do is if you can, bring your feet off the floor. And these are called Russian twists, okay? If you can't bring your feet off the floor, the next step would be 1 foot on the floor. And if you can't do that, then go ahead and put both feet on the floor. If you really can't do it, you need to do this. Put your feet under something that holds them still, like the bed or a coffee table or someone's holding your feet or something, okay? So you're gonna do 10 of those. One side counts, always one side counts when you're doing a two-way thing. So we're gonna do 10 of those. Put your ball down. Then go ahead and lay on the floor and you can just hold on to a table leg or something. You're gonna press up and down, okay? Now, if you're on the floor, you'll have to go out like that and come back up. If you're on a bench, you can come straight down like this and come up and even get a stronger stretch on your core, okay? So I'm gonna do it that way since I am on a bench, okay? So you're gonna do 20 of these. Good, after you do 20 of those, I want you to go straight into it of high knee lifts with a flat back, okay? And one side counts. You're only counting this leg 20 times. This is gonna work your whole hip flexor, all this muscle down the front. Makes your leg look really nice, okay? So press and bring it up, press and bring it up 20 times. After that, I want you to put your knees together and your feet really nice and close and tight up by your bottom. Hold on or do this. I'm gonna hold on since I'm on a bench. I want you to raise your butt as high as you can with your knees squeezed tight and press all the way up. So from your knee to your body, your shoulders, is one line, okay? So I have to extreme push it up. Extreme push it up. It's gonna tighten your buns and you wanna do this 20 times. After you've done 20 of those, I want you to spread your legs and go high. Like that, okay? You can just do it in front of a wall, no one will see you. And keep your feet up high by your butt and your feet close together. And every time you come up, you're squeezing everything here and you're gonna feel it all down in front of your thighs, okay? So you're gonna do 20 times with an extreme squeeze on top. What I mean by extreme squeeze on top is after you get there, then you squeeze it a little higher, okay? Okay, so you're gonna do 20 of those. You do the whole thing three times, okay? So you're gonna start, if you want to sit on a bench this way, I lost my weight. You can hold the weight in a chair, and you can do your twist this way too. If you don't wanna sit on the floor, maybe you've got a bad back. A lot of people with bad backs can't do these on the floor. They need to have their feet on the ground. So sit in a chair. Now, if you're doing it this way, it's gonna be a lot easier. So I want you to do 30 of these, okay? 30 of the twists, leaning back, like about a 45-degree angle if you are in a chair. If you're on the floor or a bench, you can do 20 one side counts. Okay, after you do the twists, you're gonna do press up and out 10 times. Okay, push your feet up to the sky as far as you can, 10 times. Good. After you're done with that, you're doing the high knee lifts, pressing out towards the wall, 20 times, one leg count. Oops, sorry. Hey, that happens. The next one you're gonna do, feet up close to your bottom, knees together, press as high as you can, 20 times, okay? High as you can, 20 times. After you've done 20 of those, nice and high, legs out and in. I'm sorry, up and down, 20 times with your leg, your knees apart. It's gonna be, you're gonna feel a little different. Okay, 20 times each thing, the whole thing three times, okay? That's your core and your fanning workout today, okay? One more day for the shred. See you guys. Mm-hmm.